Kevin Federline, Britney Spears' ex-husband, this week became a father for the sixth time. So if you see him, let him know.
It was announced this week that in an upcoming issue of Life with Archie, the main character Archie Andrews will die following a lifelong struggle with blue balls.
You're right. You're right.
Yeah. Katherine Heigl this week sued drugstore chain Duane Reade for $6 million after the store tweeted a paparazzi photo of her leaving one of their stores. Worse, it was after her shift. Why? Probably just researching a role.
Plans were announced this week for the world's first Ferrari hotel to open in Spain in 2016 in the new Ferrari Land theme park. It's the only theme park where your penis must be this small to ride the rides. A dog in New York City who got on the tracks of a Metro North line raced ahead of the train from the South Bronx to Manhattan before it was rescued. More amazing, it did it on a handcar. It's a little dumb.
A North Carolina man who admitted to sucking on a woman's toes at a shopping center was sentenced to a month in jail where he's expected to do very well. A topless Florida woman wearing only bikini bottoms was arrested in a local McDonald's after she was told to put on clothes, then went on a rampage overturning cash registers and eating ice cream directly from the soft serve machine. As a result, she's been demoted to assistant manager.
This Monday marks the first night of Passover. Here to teach us some Passover traditions is recent Bar Mitzvah boy, Jacob.
Hi, Cecily. Oh. Here's a free pack of Oda-Eaters from my dad, the podiatrist. He's always looking for new clients.
That is so thoughtful of you, Jacob. Hey, I know you're used to talking to your old friend Seth, but I'm pretty cool too, okay? So I think we're gonna have a lot of fun. What do you say?
Passover is a holiday rich in rituals and traditions. One of these is the Seder plate, which contains symbolic foods that are displayed, but mostly meant not to be eaten. Case in point, my mom's tuna casserole.
That's a good one, Jacob. But you know, you don't have to give like a prepared speech like at your bar mitzvah. Like, we can just talk like pals, you know?
The first item on the Seder plate is the bitter herbs, which symbolize the Jews' forced labor in Egypt. The only forced labor I know is listening to my brother Ethan practice with his music rock band. But seriously, Ethan, even though you tried a cigarette and then got mad at me when I told Mom and Dad, you'll always be my cool older brother.
Oh, that's so nice. Seems like you really love your brother. Yeah?
The next item on the Seder plate is the shank bone. It represents the offering of the Paschal lamb, while the roasted egg is a symbol of the many sacrifices of the Jewish people. Case in point, eating my mom's tuna casserole.
Oh. All right, sounds like your mom's a pretty bad cook. Hey, Jacob, how bad is she?
Oh. Haroset is made up of a mixture of apples, nuts, and spices. Honestly, it's delicious. And it's one of my most favorite things, aside from indoor recess, my new Billabong backpack, and of course, Derek Jeter and the New York Yankees.
Oh, Jacob, are you sad that it's Derek Jeter's last season? I'm sorry.
A parsley is dipped into salt water as a reminder of the tears shed during slavery. Kind of like the tears I shed when I was sent to my room for being fresh to my grandma's new boyfriend.
Oh, Jacob, you know what? I can't imagine you being fresh to anybody because you're so sweet. Yeah? Okay, again.
In conclusion, I want to thank you all for joining me on this special day. And after services, please join me in the recreation room for a small oneg where we will be serving coffee, tea, macaroons, and coconut bars. But not my mom's tuna casserole.
Oh, all right. Jacob, the Bar Mitzvah Boy, everyone. Weekend update. I'm Cecily.
I'm Colin Jost. Good night.